infamous partnerships of tyranny were being formed all over the world.
Coming to learn about us. We've been out on West 4th Street for the last 16 years, kind of an evolving project. We have art galleries, artists, studios, art classes and retreats, wedding chapel, coffee shop. We want to add pubs and small restaurants and have more and more events like the one ongoing now, which is the Nada Dada event in Reno. The artists are here showing their special perceptions on some form of artistic function. Patty Melton has been doing it for many years and has her series of drawings of old motels in Reno, and you can come interactively participate in that. Carolyn Ricketts is doing a wonderful project on the evolution of the Fukushima disaster. Her studio is just very overwhelming, and it makes one take a very good perspective on what's happening. Chris Atchison is doing portraiture, and we have Vince doing photography. We have Pam Sutton does marvelous forms of fused glass, and today she's doing her torchwork, making all kinds of things from pine cones to marbles that look like the world, the earth when it's in space. You can have a feeling of spiritualism when you visit Margie and Lo. The music yesterday went on from noon till 10:30 at night, and we had every kind of musician available. It was really amazing work. The Wildflower is evolving, and we're always looking for new ideas, and we invite you to come stay in one of our bed and breakfast rooms and have a gourmet breakfast with champagne, fresh squeezed oranges, and a torte. One of my favorite things to make is a quiche with a petite filet with gorgonzola sauce that's formed with a base of scotch. So it's a scotch gorgonzola sauce, and that's to die for. Well, if you want to go online and just put in wildflowervillage.com, you'll find the map, and you'll find pictures of our artists. You'll find pictures, shots of the wedding chapel and of the various rooms you can stay in. We even have hostel rooms and regular motel rooms. The charm of it is that it keeps evolving and changing, and our outsides are painted by people who've lived here and maybe couldn't pay rent. If you go into our coffee shop, you'll see a series of marvelous paintings done by a fellow named Scott Harvey that are very impressionistic and just awesome. Scott lived here for a number of years and painted the tall yellow sign. As you come up, you'll see a big 50-foot or 40-foot high sign that says Wildflower Village, and it talks about the galleries and the bed and breakfasts and whatever. And when you come into the coffee shop itself, the walls are plastered with works by Scott Harvey that I think are pretty awesome. Thank you for listening, and I look forward to having you come and visit here at Wildflower Village. Again, I'm Pat Campbell Cozzi, and thank you.